Hello everyone, my name is Darshan Singh and I am the head of IELTS training at Target 9. Today we are going to start with our class and our topic for today is complex sentences. So when it comes to the IELTS speaking and writing especially, it is very important and crucial to use complex sentences in order to get good band. So today we are going to discuss some of the connectors that can be used to formulate some complex sentences. So first of all, I will explain to you that what complex sentences is. If you can clearly see on the board, I've written two different sentences. Now sentence number one is, I like to eat the candy. Sentence number two is, before I watch a movie. So if you can clearly see that one of these two sentences is complete sentence and the other one is incomplete. So the complete sentence is this, I like to eat the candy. So complete sentences are known as independent clause, whereas the incomplete sentence is known as dependent clause. So the major reason why students are not able to get banned in their speaking and writing is either they use only the independent clauses, and some students use independent and separately they use dependent clause. They are not able to make complex sentences. So until and unless you don't make complex sentences, you are not going to get good band score in your IELTS. So I'll show you right now that how you can use different connectors to formulate different complex sentences. So if you can clearly see these two sentences, this is the independent clause and this is dependent clause. Now before is a connector. So if I use this connector in the middle, I can combine these two sentences. So the sentence will look like this. I like to eat the candy before I watch a movie. So before is a connector, and by using connector you can connect two sentences and you can form a complex sentence. Okay, so guys, I've chosen 12 connectors and I've made complex sentences on those. I'm just going to go aside for a second and you can take a screenshot and then you can read these sentences. Now you can clearly see that I've used the connectors in the middle. So this is how you make complex sentences. It is very important to use connectors. These words are very, very crucial in IELTS. When you write the essay, it is suggested that in your second and the third para, you must have at least two complex sentences each in both the paragraphs. In your speaking as well, when you speak on QCA topics, it is very important to use this sort of a language by using more and more connectors and formulating your sentences in a complex way. Simple sentences won't fetch you more than 7 band. If you need 6 or 6.5, then it is fine. But if you are aiming 7, 7+, or 8, or even 9 band, so you need to follow this strategy and you have to use these connectors. I've written these 12 connectors. You can take a screenshot and then you can memorize these connectors. And don't try to memorize the sentences. Try to make your own sentences for practice. So guys, as we have already discussed that complex sentences is a very integral part when it comes to the IELTS essay, task 1 and speaking. Apart from that, using repetitive words also contributes to the reduction of your IELTS band. So it is very important to use synonyms for the most repetitive words. I've written a few words that keeps on repeating themselves again and again. So what we are going to do is, I'm going to show you some synonyms that you must use in your tasks. So and is a very common word. It's a connector, or in place of and, you can use as well as. You can also use moreover.
You can also use in addition, and you can also use also. But you can use whereas in the place of but. You can use while, however, nevertheless, because. For the reason that, and since, agree, disapprove and deny, good. Good is a very simple word. You should just erase it off your dictionary and use great, amazing, tremendous, fabulous, fantastic, bad. You can use terrible. You can also use this word, awful. Now this is a very common word which you use at least a couple of times in your essay, for an example. So instead of writing for an example, you can write for an instance, or you can also use to exemplify. Important. You can use crucial, integral, essential. So I'm just going to go on the site. You can take a screenshot and you can learn these words. Okay, so guys, on the board I have written an essay question, and using these connectors that I have told you in this video, the formula of making the complex sentences, the 12 connectors, and the few repetitive words with synonyms that I have used, you must use all of those words and try to use as much as possible and use those words in this essay. Now, we are going to discuss the ideas about this essay. First, I would also like to tell you some detailed information about the format of an IELTS essay. So when it comes to the format, there are certain points to keep in mind. The first one is number of words. You must write at least 250 words for the whole essay, and you mustn't exceed the 300 word limit mark. So your essay should stay between 250 and 300. Approximately, you know, 270, 80 is the perfect limit. The second, number of paragraphs. You must always make 4 paragraphs. The first one is always the introduction. Second one is the body one, or you can also call it the main paragraph. Third one is the body two, and the last one is the overall or conclusion. In introduction, it is suggested that you mustn't write more than 30 to 40 words, 100 to 120 words for the main para, for the main body para one. For the body para two, it should be around 80 to 100. And for the overall, again 30 to 40. So if you take an average, it will be around 260 to 280, which is, according to me, the perfect limit for an IELTS essay. So when you start writing your essay, you must always keep in mind that your alignment should always be on the left-hand side of the page. You should not leave a gap before starting a paragraph, and this is true for all the paragraphs. For all the 4 paragraphs, your alignment should be on the left hand side. This is the first thing that you need to remember about the format. Second, that you must leave a line between every paragraph. Okay, you must leave a line. Another important aspect to remember about the IELTS essay is
And both the writing task is that you must always write your task with pencil. I am not talking about the computer delivered test, because in that you will be giving the test on computer. But when it comes to the general or the academic pen and paper based test, so in that you must always use pencil, because there can be a lot of mistakes or the errors that you can make. And while proofreading, you can easily correct those errors if you write with pencil. But if you write with pen, you don't have an option. You will only be doing cutting, so it will again contribute to the reduction of your IELTS band. So this is the formula. This is the format of the essay that you must follow. The first one I'm going to repeat quickly. Number of words, minimum 250, maximum 300, and this is the word limit for each paragraph. There will always be four paragraphs for an IELTS essay: introduction, main para, body one, body two, and the overall. And third, your alignment should always be on the left hand side, plus you must always leave a line between each paragraph. Okay, so now we are going to start with this essay. As you can clearly see that in essay we have three questions. The first one is, what is obesity? The second one is, how does it occur? The third one is, how can we control it? So this is going to be my first para. I will introduce the obesity. The second para will be that how does it occur? And the third one, the solutions, the remedies to control it. My fourth para is invisible. So it will be closing. I have to pack the essay in the end. I have to give a nutshell. I have to give a conclusion. So let's begin with para number one. What is obesity? So my first line will be explaining the thing obesity. Obesity is the extra fat on the body, right? It is a dangerous disease, as simple as that, because it leads to many other diseases like heart problems, sugar, and it is also one of the main reasons behind laziness of a person. So I've written only four lines, and it will be around 30 to 40 words, and I have just given the outside thing about obesity. So I have written, the extra fat on the body is known as obesity. It is a very dangerous disease, and it leads to many other diseases as well, like heart disease, sugar problems, and it also contributes to the laziness of a person. So this is going to be my introduction. Now this second para, how does it occur? So I'll state there are many reasons behind obesity. So if you can see this word, this is a very common word, many. So in spite of many, I will use numerous, or you can also use myriad of. Numerous and myriad of. That there are myriad of reasons, or you can also write factors behind obesity. I think the first one is very clear: the lifestyle of a person. Going to bed late and getting up late in the morning. So this is the main reason behind obesity. And eating a lot of fast food or oily food. Another reason could be no physical exercise, no walking or less walking. You can also compare that in the past people used to walk a lot, so they were fitter, but nowadays not many people do walking. So this is the main reason behind obesity. So even if you have three or four good points with you in your second para, it is more than enough. So you can use those complex sentences, you can use those repetitive words that I give you, and then you can formulate the sentences for these ideas. Now the third para, how can we control it? So there are many things that you can do to control obesity. The first one is, you can exercise. And then you can also mention from your opinion that how many hours a person should do exercise, 1 to 2 hours every day. And you can also suggest, you can give an example that the World Health Organization suggests that a person must take at least 8,000 steps in one day in order to remain fit. So WHO
World Health Organization suggests that 8,000 steps
minimum for every person in one day in order to remain fit.
You can give this example. This is a true example for this essay, right? Now the first one is exercise. A person can choose healthy food options, nutritious food. You can eat more and more fruits and raw vegetables.
So these are the points that you are going to write. Now, let me just explain you one thing. When you go in your IELTS exam, there are around 300 to 400 students in the hall. So most of the students will have these same ideas. But where it makes the difference is that how you formulate your sentences. Because even if a person writes the same ideas, he can get 7 and the other one can get 5. Because there is a difference in how they make sentences. So the ideas doesn't make a difference to a certain extent, but what is the thing that makes most difference is your use of complex sentences and the use of vocabulary and the use of non-repetitive words. So this is the thing you have to keep in mind. Now this is the first para, this is the point for second para, and this is the point for third para. Now how will you close your essay? Many students ask me this thing, that they find difficulty in closing the essays. So I have a very simple solution for those students. You must always see the first line of the essay question and then you will find your closing. Now my first line was obesity. So obesity is a disease that leads to many other diseases, that is a major problem and it needs to be solved, because they were also asking for solutions. So how will you formulate your closing? You can write in a nutshell, I would like to say that this disease needs to be tackled as soon as possible, otherwise we would face the serious consequences of it. So I'm just going on the side and you can take a screenshot for the ideas and for the introduction and also for the overall part. So you must practice this essay by using the connectors and the words that I have given to you.